You don't need a fancy controller to create cool LED effects, just this tiny chip. Hey guys, in this video, I'll show you how to make LED night effects using the 555 timer and CD4017 ICs. Stay tuned to the second part of this video, where I'll explain how this circuit works. Here are all the components you need to set up this circuit. 23 jumper wires, 10 LEDs, 1 LDR, 1 10 microfarad capacitor, a 1N4007 diode, 1 10,000 ohms resistor, 1 330 ohms resistor, 1 555 timer IC, 1 CD4017 IC, a battery holder with 4 AA batteries for the power source, a breadboard to connect everything together. The 555 timer IC comes with 8 pins. There is a notch or a dot on the chip's body. Pin 1, located at the top left, serves as the ground or ground supply. Pin 2, the trigger pin, initiates the timing interval in monostable and astable modes. Pin 3 serves as the output, providing the timer's operational result depending on its mode: monostable, astable, or bistable. Pin 4, the reset pin, is used to reset the 555 timer's internal flip-flop. Pin 5 serves as the control pin, enabling you to adjust the threshold voltage levels used by the internal comparators to set and reset the flip-flop. Pin 6, the threshold pin, monitors the voltage of the capacitor in the circuit. Pin 7, the discharge pin, manages the timing capacitor's charge and discharge cycle. Pin 8, known as VCC, supplies power to the IC. Let's set up the circuit step by step. Begin by positioning the 555 timer IC on the breadboard. The pins are numbered counterclockwise, starting from the top left corner. Refer to the later circuit diagram if you have questions about the circuit connections. Insert the 555 timer in the middle of the breadboard. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 2 or trigger to pin 6 or threshold. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 4 or reset to pin 8 or VCC. A jumper wire connects pin 1 or ground to the negative rail. Insert a 10 microfarad capacitor into pin 2 or trigger in the negative rail. Insert the shorter leg into the negative rail. Insert a 1N4007 diode into pin 8 or VCC in the positive rail. Insert the cathode into pin 8. Insert an LDR into pin 6 or threshold and pin 7 or discharge. Bend the ends of a 10,000 ohms resistor. Insert the 10,000 ohms resistor to pin 4 or reset and pin 7 or discharge. The notch or dot of the CD4017 should be at the top. Insert the CD4017 in the middle of the breadboard. Insert a jumper wire into pin 8 and the negative rail. Insert a jumper wire into pin 16 and the positive rail. Insert a jumper wire into pin 15 and the negative rail. Insert a jumper wire into pin 13 and the negative rail. Insert a jumper wire into pin 3 of the 555 timer and pin 14 of the CD4017. Insert a jumper wire into pin 3 and the bottom of the breadboard. Pin 3 is connected to the first LED. Insert one leg of the LED in the same row as the jumper wire and the other a few rows below it. Connect a jumper wire between the same row as the LED's shorter leg and the negative rail. Connect pin 2 to the second LED. Insert one leg of the LED in the same row as the jumper wire and the other in the negative rail. Insert the shorter leg in the negative rail. Connect pin 4 to the third LED. Connect pin 7 to the 4th LED. Connect pin 10 to the 5th LED. The 5th LED has the same setup as the 1st LED, with both legs in the middle of the breadboard. Connect pin 1 to the 6th LED. Connect pin 5 to the 7th LED. Connect pin 6 to the 8th LED. Connect pin 9 to the 9th LED. Connect pin 11 to the 10th LED. Bend the ends of a 330 ohms resistor. Insert the 330 ohms resistor in the negative rail. Use a jumper wire to connect the negative rails. It's time to connect the power supply. Attach the negative lead from the battery holder to the negative rail. Attach the positive lead from the battery holder to the positive rail. We have successfully completed the circuit. The LED cycles on and off quickly in a circular sequence. When I put my hand over the LDR, the LED slowly turns on and off, one after the other. But when I remove my hand, they start flashing quickly again. When I lower the lights, the LEDs gently turn on and off, one after another. Let's dive into the circuit and break it down step by step. The 555 timer is configured in a stable mode, continuously generating square wave pulses at its output, or pin 3. The LDR's resistance is low or less than 1,000 ohms in daylight. This causes the charging and discharging cycle of the capacitor to be fast. So, the 555 produces faster pulses, and the 4017 quickly cycles through the LEDs and creating a chasing effect. In darkness, the LDR's resistance increases significantly, or around thousands of ohms. The capacitor charges and discharges much more slowly, so the pulse frequency drops, and the 4017 receives fewer clock pulses. This results in only one LED lights up at a time, and it stays on for much longer, which means the chasing effect slows down dramatically. The 4017 takes pulses from the 555 and activates its output pins one after another, Q0 to Q9. Each output is connected to an individual LED through a 330 ohms resistor. This creates the sequencing or chasing effect. I hope this video has shown you how to make LED night effects with a 555 timer and a CD4017. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, consider subscribing for more electronics tips and tutorials, and hit the bell icon to never miss an update. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.